Hello YouTube and Facebook people, welcome back to my videos. Today's video is a what sold video. It's been a while since I've made one of these videos. It's been a while since I've made any videos, but last weekend I had a sale in my Poshmark closet and here are the results that I had. It was pretty successful, so thank you to anybody that shopped in my closet. I do appreciate it. So I had, I think I counted 29 sales from that sale that I had. So I wasn't sure if I wanted to just talk really, really, really fast and make it a shorter video, make it a watchable length, or if I just want to make it a longer video and you can just put this on in the background while you work, or you can sit down with some popcorn, a 5-course meal, because that's how long it's going to take, and watch this video. We'll see. Hopefully this does not end up being too horribly long. But here we go. So for my sale, I went onto Instagram and I made a post. I believe I made a post and I also made a story, and then I shared that story to my Facebook. And that's all the advertising that I did. I didn't have any in ads in. Oh my goodness, the wording on this is spectacular. Yeah, that's all I did. I went onto Instagram and I just said, hey, I'm having a sale, come make me an offer and I will probably accept it. Like I've been saying for a while now, I'm trying to get my closet to be an all mountainy brands slash vintage Poshmark closet. That's just what I like to sell, so that's what I want to focus on. So everything else in my closet, I'm just trying to scooch out the door while not losing money. So I started at the bottom of my Poshmark closet. I don't know about anybody else, but for me, when I'm sharing my Poshmark closet, I like to have what I like to think of like my good stuff, the goods, at the top of my closet, and then all of the other randomness is at the bottom. So I started at the bottom of my closet and went up, and I did offers to likers to absolutely everything in my closet that had likes. Not everything in my closet has likes. I went from the bottom to top sending offers, and I let people in my stories know that, so that if you want something, come make a bundle, make me an offer, because I'm not gonna get to that item until I get to the item. I was trying to stay in order to stay focused and make it go quicker. It actually took me a whole afternoon to send offers to everybody. I believe I had over 500 listings in my closet, so it does take a while to send offers to likers. And here are my results. Like I said, 29 items sold. A few of those are bundles. I'm very grateful. And again, thank you anybody that purchased. That's 3 minutes already. Let's hop into it. Like usual, I'm gonna go ahead and pop up a photo right here so that you guys can see what I'm talking about. The first thing that sold was this headband. There was no branding on it. I found this at the bins and I thought that the style of it was very Free People, Anthropology looking. So I picked it up. I mean, it's the bins, it was cheap. This sold for $10. So after Poshmark fees, that left me with $7.05. I'm also gonna do all of the totaling at the very end of this video to hopefully make this go faster. The next thing that sold was a pair of exercise shorts. They were the brand Kalia. I got these at a garage sale, so they were super, super cheap. They ended up selling for $20, and after Poshmark fees, I had $16 left. Next sale was a pair of Hudson jeans. These were a kid's jeans. Normally I don't pick up kids' sizes because I know nothing about children's clothing, but I knew they were Hudson and I knew they were cute, so I went ahead and took a gamble. I got these at the bins. They ended up selling for $8 with a discounted shipping, so that left me with $2.93. I still made a profit, not very much of a profit, but live and learn. I also think that's part of selling children's clothes. People don't want to pay up for kids' clothes because they're just going to stain them or grow out of them. So lesson learned, I think if you're selling kids' clothes, maybe you need to sell them in bigger lots than just one item. The next thing that sold, again, there was no brand name. I picked it up solely on the style. I thought it was cute. It is this floral skirt. It was a plus size and I thought it was really, really cute. This sold for $8 with discounted shipping. So again, I got $2.93, but I picked this up at the bins. This next thing that sold was my first bundle. It had three items in it. The girl contacted me on Poshmark saying that she saw my Instagram post, which I thought was really, really cool. Just for the fact that she said that and that she saw my Instagram story, I gave her an extra discount on this. The first item in the bundle is this Free People top. I picked this up at the bins. It is a really sought after style if you are selling Free People. I find that if it has intricate embroidery, it does good. And also if it's like an oversized flowy type thermal, those sell really good as well. I'm surprised that this one didn't sell sooner, but that's okay. The next item in the bundle is just a t-shirt that I picked up. It is by the brand Anthropology, well, more specifically Little Yellow Button. When I saw this at the thrift store, I saw Anthropology and I was like, yes, I need to have this in my closet. This was back before I knew that not all Anthropology is created equally. So I did pay up a little bit because I bought this at my Honey Hole. Not too much, I think maybe $4 for it. It was $4 too much, but that's okay. Also in this bundle is a purse that I picked up at the bins. Again, no brand. I picked it up because of the style. It had this really cool boho feeling to it. I went ahead and sent her an offer of $18 with discounted shipping. So after Poshmark's fees, that left me with $12.28. Again, I did not get rich off of this bundle, but it's good to get my money back so I can reinvest it and I have room out in my inventory. Next thing that sold was another bundle. This one had four items in it. First thing in this bundle is a Talbot skirt. I got this out of a mystery box. Second thing are these Vince Camuto flats. Super, super cute. They were leather and they had like sequins on the toes. Super cute. I picked these up at the bins. Next in that bundle is this Vineyard Vines vest. I picked this up. Was it a mystery box? I don't think it was a mystery box, but it was a bundle that I purchased, but it was a bundle for me and I just never ended up wearing this. So I went ahead and sold it. And then lastly is this Kate Spade silk top. This is actually one that I recently picked up. I threw it in the sale though, because it's not one of the mountainy brands that I'm looking to have in my closet. That I picked up at New Horizons, my Honey Hole. And when I say recent, I mean my most recent trip. That was before all of this nonsense in the world started happening. I sent her an offer of $48 with discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $36.28. Next item to sell was this Nike top. It was like a half sleeve or three-quarter sleeve. Nothing special, had the little logo. I sent an offer for $10 with discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $4.93. Next thing to sell, I was a little bit sad to see it go because I kind of wanted to keep it for myself. They were these Express jeans, but they had this embroidery detail on the legs. Super, super cute jeans. I sold them for $20 with a discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $13.88. Sorry if you see my eyes keep going back and forth. I'm looking at my computer screen because there's no way on earth I can remember all of these numbers. Let's see here. Next thing that sold was this Apartment 9 top. I got this at the bins. It's a cute top, but this was like back in the day when I wasn't even considering brand at all. I'd go to the bins and I'd find a piece. If it didn't have any stains or any holes or anything, I put it in my cart and I bought it. This one sold for $8 with discounted shipping, so Poshmark gave me $2.93. This next item I picked up at a church sale, so it was super, super cheap. It was a Norton McNaughton vintage like skirt and top set. Really, really cute. It has the skirt and then like the matching short sleeve shirt. I sent an offer for $10, discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $4.93. Next thing to sell is this Brooks Brothers blazer. Again, this was back in the day when I was picking up a lot of stuff that I heard other YouTubers talking about. Brooks Brothers was a brand that I heard a lot of bigger YouTubers talking about. It is an expensive brand to buy it brand new from the retail store, but as far as reselling goes, at least for me, I haven't had the best of luck. Maybe it's because I'm picking up not the nicest styles, I'm not sure. But Brooks Brothers, it was a blazer size 2, so it was a little bit smaller. I don't know if that had anything to do with it. $10 discounted shipping, Poshmark gave me $4.93. This one I picked up back in the day when I first started doing Poshmark. The brand is Boomerang, which is a Swedish brand. Maybe this would have done better on eBay, but I am not an eBayer. yet. So this blazer is brand Boomerang, and retail, again, this is a very, very high-end brand. It sells for crazy amounts brand new, but resale value, especially on Poshmark, wasn't that good. I had difficulty looking up comps for Poshmark, and when I started it out, I did have it on the higher end, but nobody on Poshmark, I think, knew what this brand was. That's okay, I got my money back out of it, what I spent. So I picked this up at regular Goodwill. I sent out an offer for $13 with discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $7.93. Next are these Michael Kors work pants. These I picked up in a mystery box. I believe it was from my Thrifting Wonderlester box. I never made a video about that box. We're not gonna get into that either. But finally, something from the box sold, so that's awesome. I sent out offers for $10 with discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $4.93. And I do believe I made my money back, because those boxes are expensive. I made my money back by a few pennies, so that's good. Next item is from another mystery box. Yeah, I lost money on this one. This came from... I don't want to name names, but you can go watch this video. I'll have it linked down below. The mystery box is from another YouTuber reseller. I sent out offers for $7 with discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $1.93, so I probably lost around $5. I'm not sure. That's the thing about mystery boxes. You never know what you're gonna get. Why do I always quote Forrest Gump in my videos? Next up is another blazer. I am surprised at how many blazers sold, especially for the weather. But it's Coldwater Creek, and it was this really cool blazer. It had a bunch of embroidery. It was pretty snazzy looking. I sent out offers for $9 with discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $3.93. Next up is this t-shirt. This has been in my closet for a while as well. It's this AC/DC burnout tee. I picked it up at a garage sale for super cheap. I sent out offers for $10 with discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $4.93. Next up, this was actually from the Thrifting Wonderlusters box as well. This one I lost money on. It was a Zara top, button-up top. It did have one flaw on it, I believe, which I did picture and note in the description. It had a small stain on it. I sent out offers for $7 with discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $1.93, so I did end up losing money on this one. But the thing is, with losing money, I mean, at least I got $1.93 back to reinvest. Because if I didn't sell any of these things that are getting pushed out of my closet, then they're just gonna go to my sister, Smelly Melly, to her garage sale. So at least I'm getting something back from these mystery boxes and these bad buys. Next up is another bundle. This one has four items in it. The first thing is this DC Comics Joker tank top. This was in my closet, I believe, from the very beginning of when I started Poshmark. I picked it up at a regular Goodwill, but it was pretty cheap. I think it was like $2. The next thing in this bundle is a pair of Fabletics workout pants. These came from a mystery box from Nick Pick Thrift. The next thing in here is a pair of Victoria's Secret leggings. I got these at the bins. And then the last thing are these Vans. They're pretty cool. They were like galaxy print. These were free. My sister-in-law gave these to me. So I ended up selling this bundle at $34 with discounted shipping. So Poshmark gave me $25.08. I ain't mad at it. Next thing that sold is another thing that I was a little sad to see go because I wanted to keep it. It was this J. Crew super, super chunky knit sweater. It's like a Charlie Brown looking sweater. I paid $1 for it at a garage sale. It sold for $17 with discounted shipping, so Poshmark gave me $11.48. This next item was a pretty popular item in my closet. A lot of people I saw added this to their bundle. I ended up sending out offers of $25 with discounted shipping. And I figured if nobody wanted to pay that much for it, then it would just sell in some random person's bundle. But somebody did purchase it for that price, so Poshmark gave me $17.88. And I believe I picked this one up when we went to Pennsylvania last year, last October. I want to say I paid like $3 or $4 at this random little thrift store. Next thing to sell was this Cabela's top, nothing special, just a long sleeve top. I sent out offers for $11 with discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $5.93. This next item that sold, the person got a heck of a deal. It's Rag & Bone, which if you don't know, is a really good brand of jean. I sent out offers of $21 with discounted shipping, so that left me with $14.68. I wanna say I picked those up at a regular Goodwill, but I do sometimes find it at my bins. Next thing to sell were these Level 99 jeans. If you don't know, that's an Anthropologie brand. I sold these for $18 with discounted shipping, and that gave me $12.28. Next up was a pretty cool sale. This is my first, this is my second high-end sale. First time finding Chanel. This was a size 8 blazer, light pink. There really wasn't anything special to it. I found this at the bins, so it probably cost me around 80 cents. I would have put my price higher for this, but there was some discoloration on the sleeve, which I'll go ahead and show you a picture of it as well. I noted all that, took pictures. I had it listed for $200, and this was when my sale was going on as well. And somebody sent me an offer for $100, which I sat and I had to think about for a while. But the fact that it did have the discoloration on it and it wasn't something that I wanted to deal with, I said, yeah, take it. You can have it. I'm gonna reinvest this money into something that I enjoy selling, because it is a little scary selling these high-end brands, especially if you're not an expert on it. So she sent me that offer of $100. Poshmark took out their $20, and that left me with $80. Not bad at all. 80 cents into $80. I'll take it any day. Next. That was a weird way to say next. Next thing to sell was this sweater. It is vintage. It was Sunday Comics, Mickey Mouse and Minnie Mouse sweater. I picked this one up at that church sale as well, so it was only like 24 cents. I got an offer sent to me for $23, and that left me with $18.40. The sale that I had was to get rid of non-mountainy brand items. How many times can I explain that in this video? But it was me trying to get rid of my non-mountainy, non-vintagey items. But in the process of having that sale, the whole Poshmark algorithm or whatever, once you get sales coming in, I think it boosts you up searchably and you make more sales. So this one is not part of the sale, but it did come, I believe it came because of my sale and because of the sales that I was having. This is a mountain brand. It's one of my favorite, probably my most favorite mountain brand. It's Arc'teryx, and I picked this up at New Horizons, AKA my honey hole. I paid $5.99 for this. I got an offer of $40, and that left me with $32 from Poshmark. I think it's good to have stuff in your closet that you can make a very, very quick flip on to get your algorithm boosted. To make the bigger sales. So there's that. That's just my opinion. Next thing to sell was this Kalia top. It was just a tank top, nothing too special. It had writing on it, but nothing too amazing. I sent out offers for $14 with discounted shipping. Poshmark gave me $8.93. This one I picked up at a garage sale for like 25 cents. Next thing was a 2-item bundle, and I was kind of surprised at how many sweatshirts and cardigans sold in this sale. That's what this is. It's 2 cardigans. The first one is Anthropologie Sparrow. I believe I picked this one up at my honey hole. And the next one was just a Target cardigan. I sent an offer of $16 with discounted shipping. That left me with $10.68. The last sale that I had was this men's Vineyard Vines long sleeve shirt. I sent out offers of $19 with discounted shipping, and that left me with $13.08. So I'm gonna go ahead and add everything up for you guys. Those were all of my sales that I had from having my sale. If you're struggling to make sales right now on Poshmark, I think it's a good idea to maybe have a sale. Maybe it would have been better if I marketed within my Poshmark closet. I'm not sure. I'm not sure how many people actually see that, but I do know that I have somewhat of a following on my Instagram. It's not a huge one, but I know that a lot of the people that watch my YouTube videos also follow me on Instagram. So I knew that some people would eventually see it, and some people did comment to me that they did see my story on Instagram. Also, like I was saying, I think it's a good idea to have, how do I word this? Lower investment items that you don't mind selling for very, very cheap and making very, very little. So pay very little and sell it for not a lot, just to get the algorithm going in your closet, just to make those sales, to get the ball rolling. Just an idea. It's worked for me in the past. It worked for me in this sale. Is that all the advice I have? Advice that nobody asked for? Just a quick shout out to the Canadians for pushing me to get a video out this week. Thank you. I do appreciate it. There is Chris at ThriftBCQ, Cliff the Canadian Pickle at Boondock Mercantile, and Jody at Jody Matoma's Videos. They'll all be linked down below. Also linked down below is my Poshmark closet. Also down there is my Instagram. It's my personal page. Also linked down below are the automotive YouTubers that I enjoy watching. So go check everyone out, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.